If you have a problem where the filter doesn't seem to be including data after a certain row, it could be the way you set the filter up. So here we've got a filter, it's on, I've got lots of data here. So I'm just gonna go and let's go look at all the SPO1s. And you'll see it doesn't seem to have done anything here. So for some reason, it only got up to row 10, it only found the first one. I'm just gonna show all. Now the reason for this, in all likelihood, I'm just going to switch my filter off, is a lot of people, instead of telling Excel explicitly where to look, they click over here, they click the filter button, and they hope Excel guesses right. And the problem with Excel is it guesses, and what it's done is it's included that area there. So the moment it hits a blank, it stops. It assumes you don't want that data in. And in this case, it's very messy data, but I do want it in. Just to show you again, if I choose that, you can see it hasn't included it. I'm just going to clear it. So the correct way to do it is you highlight everything. Now you don't need to switch it off and then highlight everything and switch it on. I'm going to click on this, go right to the last bit of the data, hold my shift key down, click it. It's all highlighted. I'm going to switch the filter off. So the old filter is switched off, and immediately I push again. And if I go to the top, the filter's on, doesn't look any different. But now when I ask for cell person one, you'll see I get all the information that I was looking for.